Welcome to another session of Biology Crash Course. Today we are going to cover most important MCQ based factual points for topics like cell organelles, where we are going to cover both lysosomes and centrosomes in this session. So keep watching. Make sure you follow my Facebook page Bio with Sruthi and my Instagram account for all the further updates of the videos. You can also contact me through my Gmail ID for any kind of further queries or any kind of help with respect to biology, okay, with respect to biology subject when it comes to government exams. All the link will be there in the description. So let's begin with the session. Some important MCQ based factual points for lysosomes. When it comes to government exams, you have to remember lysosomes was discovered by Dewey. Who discovered lysosomes? Dewey. Remember, ribosomes was discovered by Pillai, but lysosomes was discovered by Dewey. So don't get confused between ribosomes and lysosomes. Okay, let's discuss some important points when it comes to structure of lysosomes. See, lysosomes are sac-like structure. Sac hota na goni. It looks like goni. Sac. So these are sac-like structure which contains hydrolytic enzymes. So you can imagine a sac, a goni, which contains hydrolytic enzymes. Ash is a sac-like cell organelle which contains hydrolytic enzymes. It is lysosomes. This is very important for you to understand what you mean by hydrolytic enzymes. Because only when you know this term, it will be easy for you to remember the function of lysosomes, which is also important. So let's discuss what are hydrolytic enzymes. See, first of all, what are enzymes? See, enzymes are chemical molecules which helps to speed up any kind of biochemical reaction. What are biochemical? Bio is your body, and any kind of chemical reaction which takes place inside your body. Let's take some examples like respiration, digestion, excretion, etc. There are so many processes which takes place inside your body. In order to increase the speed of these processes, we have enzymes. Okay, let me give you some example. Jaise, you know, for example, we eat chapati. Now, the moment you eat chapati, you chew it. You know, this chapati, this complex chapati is broken down. It becomes soft. It converts into bolas, a ball-like structure, right? And that is because of saliva. See, the moment you eat chapati, saliva comes in. You know, it makes the chapati soft. What it does, it makes the chapati easy to swallow. It helps in digestion. It helps in quick intake of the food, right? So saliva contains enzyme to do this. It's because of the enzyme present in the saliva because of which digestion process becomes easy. Like that, you have enzymes, you know, to help such chemical reaction. So this is enzyme, this is the function of enzyme, right? It helps to speed up the process. Now what do you mean by hydrolytic enzyme? For that you need to understand what is hydrolysis or hydrolytic. See, in biology, whenever lysis, hydrolytic, lysis means breaking down. You are breaking down something. So when I'm saying hydrolytic enzyme, lytic means you're breaking. What are you breaking? You're breaking hydrogen bond. Hydrolytic. You're breaking hydrogen bond. Okay. See, what are hydrogen bond? You know, these chemical molecules, take example of carbohydrate, protein, you know, these are big molecules. And these big molecules are attached together. Na? They are glued together. There is a glue. There is a gum. This gum is hydrogen bond. Because of the hydrogen bond, you can say they are come close together. Now, if I remove this glue or gum or hydrogen bond, the molecules will break down, the molecules will destroy. Am I correct? So, that is the meaning of hydrolysis. Hydrolysis means what? Hydrogen, you are breaking. Lysis means you are breaking what? You are breaking hydrogen bond of this molecule. So, the molecules will break down. So, that is the function of hydrolytic enzymes. That is the function of lysosome. Lysosome is a sac-like cell organelle which contains hydrolytic enzymes. And this hydrolytic enzymes, okay, enzymes helps to speed up the process. Which kind of process? It helps to break down the molecule. Large, big, complex molecules, lysosomes break these molecules down with the help of enzymes. And these enzymes helps for hydrolysis, that is breaking of this molecule. That's why these enzymes are called as hydrolytic enzymes. Enzymes which helps in hydrolysis or in the breakdown of molecules, that is hydrolytic enzyme. Are we clear? See, this was very important in order to understand the function of the lysosome. Okay, so I had to explain. Further, we will see when we will understand function of the lysosome. Now, we will discuss them more. Lysosome is a single membrane bound cell organelle. Question, which of the following cell organelle is a single membrane bound cell organelle? Mitochondria, chloroplast, ribosome, lysosome. Answer, lysosome. It is the lysosome which is a single membrane bound cell organelle. See, if you take the example of mitochondria, chloroplast, both are double membrane bound. Ribosome is a membrane, it does not have any membrane. Okay, but in case of lysosome, it is a membrane bound and a single membrane bound cell organelle. So, it is a single membrane bound, but it is a membrane bound cell organelle. That's why it is present in eukaryotic cell, but it is absent in prokaryotes. Okay, it is present in eukaryotes, but it is not there in prokaryotic cell. Now, where is lysosome exactly present in the cell? It is present in the cytoplasm. You can see in the image only carefully. Where is it present? It is present in the cytoplasm of the cell. Now, let's discuss about some important functions with respect to government exams when we are talking about lysosomes. Which of the following cell organelle helps in the intracellular digestion? It is lysosomes. See, lysosomes helps in the intracellular digestion. You know what is intracellular digestion? See, there are few biological terms that you have to remember so that it will be easy for you to tick the MCQs, you know, tick the answer. See, when I'm saying inter means between. If the term comes now, intercellular means between the cell. For example, take the example inter-school, inter-college, you know, between the schools. Inter-school competition between the school, right? Inter-college. So, intercell between the cell. But if I'm telling intracellular, so intra means within the cell. So, when I'm saying intracellular digestion, if any kind of molecule, any kind of material, when it enters inside the cell, lysosomes helps to digest. It helps to digest. Okay, now what is there in the lysosome which helps in this intracellular digestion? So that is hydrolytic enzyme. Remember we said in digestion in our mouth we have saliva. Saliva has an enzyme to help in digestion. Similarly, lysosomes have hydrolytic enzymes to help in this intracellular digestion. So whatever material comes inside the cell, it digests. So the question can come, which of the following cell organelle is hydrolytic in function? Which of the following cell organelle is hydrolytic in function? Mitochondria, Golgi body, plastids or lysosomes? Answer, lysosomes. Remember, lysosomes are hydrolytic in function. See, when I'm talking about lysosome, now you need to understand lysosome is very important for your body. You know, it's very important for the cell. It acts as a guardian or you can say watchman or a protector. You know, the moment any kind of bacterial cell or disease causing cell or maybe a cancerous agent, if it enters the cell, for example, a bacterial cell enters inside the cell. What the lysosomes do, they digest the entire bacterial cell. They have these hydrolytic enzymes which help to break the bacterial cell. It breaks up the bacterial cell. It breaks up the bonds by which the bacterial cell is made up of. So, it breaks them and it digests. Like that, it destroys the complete bacterial cell or it destroys the organism which will cause you disease. So that's why this is also called a suicidal bags. It kills, it destroys the organism. So remember, lysosome is also known as suicidal bags. Are you understand? So it basically protects your body from any kind of foreign material, infectious agents. So lysosome is very important. So which of the following cell organelles is also known as suicidal bags? Mitochondria, chloroplast, ribosome, lysosome. It is lysosomes. Because mitochondria is called as ATP, powerhouse of the cell. Chloroplast helps in photosynthesis. And ribosomes are called as last protein factory. So, it is lysosomes. These are called as suicidal bags. Are we clear with the concepts? Let's move forward with centrosomes.
Make sure you subscribe my channel if you're liking my video and please press the bell icon for further notification. Another important point which you have to remember is lysosomes are not found in RBC or red blood corpuscles, also called as red blood cells of mammals. Please remember, lysosomes are absent in the RBC of mammals. Okay, in the RBC of which organism? Mammals. Now, what are mammals? Mammals are those organisms which give birth to young ones, which don't reproduce using eggs. Wo ande se nahi reproduce karte. They give birth to young ones. Like, look at the following image. You know, you can see panda and a baby panda, chimpanzee, humans, dogs, cats, you know, all these organisms comes in mammal because we give birth to young ones. So, in the RBC of mammals, lysosomes are absent.
Here we are going to discuss few important factual points with respect to centrosomes for government exams. See, first of all, centrosome was discovered by Boveri. You have to remember this. See, discovery, function, this is important. Okay, so centrosome was discovered by Boveri. Now, when you look at this centrosome, remember, centrosome is only and only present in animal cell. Cell organelle centrosome is present in which of the following cell of organism? Animal cell, plant cell, both of them, none of them. Answer, animal cell. Centrosome is only present in animal cell. In animal cell, it helps in cell division. Remember, centrosome helps in cell division, which we'll know further when we are talking about the function. Now, centrosome does not have any membrane, just like ribosome. It's not a membrane-bound cell organelle. Centrosome is not a membrane-bound cell organelle. Remember, guys, where is centrosome present? Centrosome is present in the cytoplasm. If you look at centrosome, it is close to the nucleus. Just look at the image. It is close to the nucleus, but it is present in the cytoplasm. Are we clear? So remember, centrosome has two centrioles. Each centriole has two centrioles, which helps in the cell division. Okay, and this is there in the animal cell. See, this we will discuss when we are talking about the function. We will discuss more. Okay, but if they ask you the question, which of the following statement is or are correct with respect to centrosome? Number one, centrosome is only present in animal cell. Number two, centrosome is not a membrane bound cell organelle. Number three, centrosome, each centrosome contains two centrioles. And fourth option, all of the above. So what will be the answer? All of the above. All the given sentences are right about centrosome. Are we clear? Now let's talk about the function of the centrosome. See, centrosome helps in cell division. It is only present in animal cell and it helps in cell division. Each centrosome has two centrioles. If you look at a cell, two centrosomes have two centrioles. These centrioles initiate or start the cell division. When the cell division takes place in animal cell, these centrioles start the cell division. You will find the centrioles in pole. They are always polar in nature. So you will find the centriole in the pole and they start the cell division. They initiate the cell division and form spindle fibers. You can see spindle fibers, you know, halka invisible. Fiber means patla. And why spindles? Because of the shape. It's because of the shape they are called as spindle fibers. See, with respect to government exams, you have to remember centrosome is present only and only in animal cell for cell division. And who helps them in cell division? Centrosome has two centrioles. The centrioles initiate the cell division in animal cell, thereby further forming spindle fibers. Patla dhage jaisa, there is fibers, spindle fibers. Are we clear with the concept? This is very, very important. So you give it a thumbs up, share and subscribe if you genuinely like the video. In the next session, we will cover another important topic for government exams.